Okay, and I start this my job so that I like to go inside in this my vacuum cleaner, and that's I have to open this cover, plastic cover, and there is really those Phillips head screwdrives in here, and I have in here this electric screwdriver, and I open these screws what we have in here. They look like that, and then I install all of these screws in this my box, and there is a second screw, and I install this my screws in this my box, and now these bolts are free, and then I judge that where other places there are those screws, and now I have to open that cover in here, in this area, and then I take this cleaning bag away in here, and in here we can see more of these screws, like in here, and there is my next screw, and then I install my tool in this way. Okay, and now this screw opens, good. And then I notice that in here we have also next screw in here. In that area, okay, it is in here, good. And in here is the second side, and I little bit bent that area, and then when I use like tongs and a little bit bend, then this cover opens easily. Excellent. And next in here, we have next screw in this area. And I open also that. Good. Now this is free. And then we go look these area screws in here. In here we have next screws in here. That one. In here, this small one. And then in here, similar. Okay, good. Now these screws are free. Excellent. And then in that area, in these holes, we can find the screw in here, and I use my tongs that I can take this screw out, good. There is this screw, and then in that area, I believe that in hidden in here, okay, there is no in here. And now I take also this flexible, this joint. Okay, but here is one, there is hidden one screw in here. Good. And then I rotate that my belt in here. I check that, is there anything? No, there is not anything in here. Okay, and then when I have take these screws out in here, then I can little bit bend that, and I can take this cover, this part away. Where is this start and stop switch? It is in here. Actually, it is not. Here is only this speed adjustment. What is this my vacuum cleaner speed? It is in here. It moves in that way. Now it is in here. I can adjust the speed. How much voltage is in there. And this is that part. And then in here we can see this is start and stop button in here. This one. Okay, good. In that area. And then there is one hole in here, and there is my next screw. And Now the screw opens and it is in there, like inside in there, and I need now a little bit longer pliers. Okay, and then when I have these long pliers, I can take this screw out in here, but now it seems that it is still like a little bit loosened in here, but it can be. And then in here I have next screw, what is in here very deep in that area, in there, and I open also this screw. Okay, and this is so long that I need even longer screwdriver. Okay, and then I need that long Phillips head screwdriver, what goes in this area, in this hole in here. And then I can open, this screw here, in that way. Okay, good. Now I think that all of these screws, in here is loosened. That one, this one, and this one. And now I believe that this cover could open. Okay, now it moves. Yes. In here we can see this movement. Okay, cool. I insert my fingers in here and then I lift up this body, and now this motor is free. It looks like that. Then there is this inner area where is this two cables what goes. Yes, this part controls, they control that part in here. But this is open or not. Okay, good. There is one switch. Two cables goes directly in this that back area. Okay, and then we can look this engine. Okay, and then when I think this is like engine, this electric motor, and now I am thinking that why this my motor is not working, what is wrong in there, and I can see that there is firstly quite much sand, and there is this engine's label, that what is this type. And then when I think that why this my engine is not working, I think that I have to check that what is this coils situation in here. There is this coil area, and now I have to check this area in here, that is this, is there maybe this dust is so much in here. This dusty, white dust is. And let's look soon what I found. Okay, and then I think that I take this electric motor away, and that's I have to first open this connector, this electric connector, and then there is one screw in here again, this Phillips head screw in this area, in here. I open this screw, and then I take this screw away. There is that kind of screw. Now I think this my motor. I can maybe lift this motor away. Okay, and there is my motor, and this is like support cover. what keeps that in position. Okay, good. And then this is my motor, and now I am checking that why this is not working. And there is the circuit board, and there is quite much this dust. Dust is in here inside, and there are those electric cables here. Good, okay, excellent. And then I start to measure this my motor. Okay, and now when I have in here this Miele's vacuum cleaner's engine, what is like motor in vacuum cleaner, next I have to check that why this my vacuum cleaner is not working. And there is this small circuit board, and there goes two cables in here. In that area, this one, that cable, and then the second cable in here. And now I measure that what is this my electric motor's resistance, because there must be resistance if this my motor is workable. And now for that purpose I need some electric tester, where is this resistance measurement possibility. Like in my case, now I turn on and now it measures, and now when I install that in here, now it says that there is actually small resistance when I connect this. But now I need to connect this my measurement tools in that area and then that area. And when I connect these areas, what we can see also in here, in that part and that part in here, there must be some resistance. Now I connect this one in here. And now I turn on my tool again. And let's check. And now I connect it in here. And now there is a situation that this resistance is in here is zero. And that means that now this my electric motor is broken and burn out. That this inside area is maybe black. And let's go to look again in here, these two sides, that can I see anything in here. But there is no anything, but let's look also this my measurement. Okay, now we can see in this my dashboard that what is amount when I connect this my meter in here and another meter in here. And now we can see that there is this zero amount. And that means now that this my motor is bad, but no worry, because I have extra spare part motor. Okay, and now I have really purchased this used motor from Amazon.com or eBay.com from internet, and it is just similar motor. We can see when there is this electric motor type in here, this model, what is in here, and then these things when we check that these are similar, and now I have really similar spare part motor, and now we can check these areas again and look that what is resistance now, that how much there is now this resistant when I install this my things in here and then that one. And now we can see that now there is amount in here, and let's go to look that closer. Okay, and now when I install that in here and that one in here, I turn on that, because automatically this turn off, and first that one and then that one, and now we can see that there is numbers in here. There is 5, look, there is 5 or 6 ohms. And now this tells that this engine, this electric motor, this is okay. Okay, and now I can install this engine in this my vacuum cleaner next. Okay, and there is really a situation that this my old motor, what was in That one, what is this white one? There is this electric motors, this inside area. When we look in here, we can see that there is black areas in there inside. And now when I rotate this, my blades in here, then we can see that inner area, that there are those electric coils in here, and they are in some areas, they are black, when we look in that area. And I believe that this my electric motor, it has been burned out. There has been maybe overheating, and this dust, white dust, what is in here, look. There has been bad this environment, and that's this my inner areas copper. Those coils, they have been cut and burned out like fuses. Okay, and if we look in their inner area, we can really see that there is this black things in there when we look very carefully. And then when we compare that another one, what is this like? This used spare part motor. There is everything fine in there inside when we look in there. When I rotate, there is no any bad things in there inside. No any black things in that inner area where we can see those copper coils. And especially the best thing is that when I have these ohm meter tools, this tells the truth that when I connect in these cables what goes in their inner area in this electric motor, that now when I install this, this thing says that there is 6 ohms resistance, and that tells to me that now this electric motor is okay. And next I like to also little bit, I install that my new, or this is actually used, but warranty motor in this my Miele vacuum cleaner. And next we can also look that when I open little bit these screws in here, that how works these coils, because we can also replace these coils in here, and it is easy to check. Okay, and then when I take this Torx head, this drill bit, it fits nicely in these screws in here. And now I install this my tool in there, and then I open that in that way, and there is this small screw, Torx head screw. It looks like that, small screw, and it is easy to open. And then I open all of these my screws. There's also in that area, there's the screw, and then this one. Good, now it's that one is free. And then there's the circuit board area, also similar screw in here, in that way. And now this circuit board is easy to remove. It looks like that. And we can also measure the circuit board area. And then we can see this my electric motor, what is in here. And now I think that I have to open also this area, that I can take this my motor totally out. Okay, and then I need to open this central nut, and it is 13 millimeter, and there is this my socket, and I install this my tongs in here. I keep that one blade in position in that way. I compress, and then I open. Okay, and now this nut opens, and there is this nut. It seems that it is in here, and now this nut is Free, excellent. And then I need to open this next array. Okay, and then sometimes we need to replace these Miele vacuum cleaners coils, and these are easy to take out when I removed these two screws, and now I moved that this array, and now I am checking that this seems to be quite worn out, and this is maybe the thing why this my vacuum cleaner is not working, because this is so long, that one, but this one is in here a little bit shorter. Okay, and it is like a little bit stuck. Okay, and then when I am checking that old bad motor, I notice also that when there is the circuit board and there are those connectors to this electric motor, I notice that this another one, right one, it has been burned out, look. And there is now this corrosion issue and maybe overheating, and this is like burned this connector in here, you can see. And also this connector, this another side in here, it is also black. And that means now that this engine has been so overheat that even those cables, they are black, that they are like melt down and burned badly. And now this electricity is like off in this my system. We can see also in there black area, and this is like okay. There has been big overheat in here. This is totally black in that area. Okay. Very good. That there has been really so bad situation that this engine has been burned out, because there is electricity has been burned these things in here. Okay, and now I have assembled these engines back. And now, before of this all parts back installation, I like to test with this electricity that how when I connect this electricity cable in this electricity, and then I press this switch, that how this my electric motor works. And let's test that what happens next. Then I install that one, and then when I press that one. Excellent. And now this my job is ready, and there was really two defects in this my engine. Firstly, this electric motor was bad, and also this another coil, what is in here, it was so burned out that there is like double issue. Coil was bad and motor. But now there is new used motor, what has been tested, and also those new coils. And now this my vacuum cleaner is working. And thank you for watching, my friend, and see you in next movie.